Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Precious Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you glory for the wonderful works you have done. We thank you for all that you wish to do. May your name be exalted in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we have gathered together. This is the first day of this program. I ask your presence to surround us. There are many that are on their way. Father, be with them. Amen. Glorify yourself tonight. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. May we be seated, please. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. Is there any weakness in the house? So I said, the Lord is good.
All the time.
We give God the glory for the beginning of this program. The good news is, someone's level is going to change from this night.
Amen.
We know the theme of the program, which says, discover to recover the good of this land. Discover to recover the good of this land. When we talk about the good of the land, it's not just all about money. No. Anything you can think of in life, whatever you consider that is good in life, that you are entitled to get, belongs to that category. The good of this land could be money, good cars, good house, good marriage, good job, good health, your landed paper, your citizenship. They are all the good of the land. There are so many academics. Praise the Lord. There are people who come, for example, from African continent, from Asia continent. They come here to school, get the qualification, and they go back home. You want to tell me there is no good education where they are coming from? There is a reason why they decided to move all the way to this side to get their master's, to get their PhD, to get their first degree. Because they know that when they tender the qualifications from this part of the world, they have a greater one compared to from their own country. So a lot of things that are in this land that are good that you are entitled for. I want you to get yourself prepared from this night. Because when you start smiling before the year runs out, and somebody comes and says, how does it happen? Then you should be able to tell them, this is what the Lord has done. Praise the Lord. Amen. Starting tonight, we want to look at the wrong foundation. The wrong foundation. Foundation represents the beginning of anything that you want to do. Foundation is the starting point of anything that you are doing in your life. Foundation is not only limited or restricted to when you are building a house. It's anything at all. The Bible says, before somebody lay the foundation, will he not first and foremost count the costs? The kind of foundation a builder will make for his house will determine the kind of house that he wants to erect. For example, the foundation for the condominium or the high rise that we see out there, they don't have the same foundation with the kind of building we are in now. Some of us will walk by, we drive by when they are laying the foundation of all these high rises or condominiums. We never pay attention to them. After now, just have a close look. If you happen to walk by, you see the kind of hole they will dig at first, the amount of concrete they will pour in on this corner, all to make sure that whatever level of buildings they want to put in there, it will not collapse. The foundation, all of us came from somewhere. What is your foundation? In which foundation, or what kind of foundation was laid by your parents for you? Even when you stepped into this land, what kind of foundation did you set up? A woman once said unto me and said, the things that others will do and just achieve it in a second, he said, I will struggle and struggle for years and years and years and years before I could achieve it. And by the time I struggle to get it, others achieved theirs long ago, they've gone ahead. For example, if me and somebody here, we have a target of buying a car, my foundation is wrong. And the foundation of that young man is right. And because he's having the right foundation, things are just working out easily. In a nutshell, he goes to a car dealer if he doesn't have the money. And, went to the bank, can I have a loan? And they decide to purchase that car for him. And myself, with the good credit, I go there. They say, sorry, we cannot. He bought his car already. He's already moving on. And I'm still struggling to get that car. A year after, 2 years after, 3 years after, 4 years after. He bought that same car years ago. Will he be thinking of a car now? No. What is it now after? It's how to get his own house. But I'm still struggling to get a car. 4 or 5 years later, now I have my car. He has already purchased his own house. He's ahead. Now the house is there. What is next for him? It's marriage. I'm still behind because of the wrong foundation. And I pray for somebody tonight. Whatever has affected your foundation negatively, the Lord will make it right tonight in Jesus' name. That is why you see some people, they succeed so easily. Why the other person is not doing well in the same land of Canaan that we all are living in? And in the process, you discover, well, Toronto is very bad. Is a competitive city. A lot, the cost of living is too high. I better go to Edmonton. The fellow will go to Edmonton. Before you know what is happening, he will still return back. Those are some people are now migrating back from Edmonton now, back to Toronto. Praise the Lord. Not until the foundation is made right. Even if they put that fellow in the garbage bin where they pick dollars every morning, the situation will not change because the foundation is still not right. Somebody traveled to Europe from my province, and the same person took her own brother to another part of Europe. He got Emily quite all right. He just arrived. Sister, can I have 100 euro? I need to buy this. We will send. She will send it to him. Every week, every month. It becomes a habit. And the sister asked him one day, won't you work? He said, there's no job. When you were back home, you said abroad is the target. Now you are in Europe, where others are working. You are still saying, sister, send money to me. In the same Europe. He said, go and work. What am I driving at is, he is in the environment where he can work and get money. Still, because the foundation has been made wrong, the energy is not there for him to work. He's still living a life of dependent on the sister that is living in Europe. Does the sister sleep 24 hours? No. She's working every minute of the day to make ends meet. The foundation. Psalm 11. Quickly, Psalm chapter 11. Verse 3. If the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Some version will tell you, if the foundation is faulty, what will the righteous do? It's a question that is left for us to solve. I know that some of us will say, well, the righteous will pray. The righteous will repay it. The righteous will do this. For the righteous, there is hope to rebuild the foundation. But for the unbelievers, the situation is hopeless. If the foundation be destroyed, how can the foundation be destroyed? The things you do at first, when you enter this land, determines what is in the foundation. The way you do things to make your way through determines the kind of foundation that you have. That is why we have to be very careful of the things we do. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's go to the book of Foundation. Genesis chapter 1. We are going to dwell more on Genesis in the next few minutes before we pray. Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. But the area of interest is, in the beginning, what? God. In the beginning, God. If God is not in the beginning, when you talk about the beginning, you are talking about the foundation, the starting point. Talk about Rio 2016. I believe that some of us watch the sporting activities, didn't we? How many of us did not watch it? I know that's a man with nuts. She's so busy. Amen. Talk about the Rio 2016. Where they do 4x100 relay. The person that will start the race matters a lot. When you have somebody that have big tummy to start the race, what will be the end of the journey? What will be the end of the result? It is very clear. Praise the Lord. The beginning. See, when they put somebody who is very fast at the beginning, the chance that those people will win at the end is very, very great. The Bible says in the beginning, God. And this is where some of us who come into this land, whether as refugee or as immigrant, we missed it. For those who declare as refugee, the first thing they step into once they get into this place, how do I get a lawyer? At the point I've mentioned to Ross one time, I know of a particular woman in this land, very close to me. She has done everything that she needs to do, and she prepared to go. And I called her and said, woman, come. Don't go there. Because every minute I always hear her saying, my lawyer, my lawyer, my lawyer, my lawyer. And I said, come, woman. Do not depend on your lawyer. I've not been to any hearing in this land. By his mercies, I came as an immigrant. I've not been to it, so I don't know how it looked like. He said, don't depend on your lawyer. She is the only woman, myself and my wife, we followed to her hearing. We followed her. How close we were. We sat at the reception. The lawyer was there with her. It was so tough to the extent that they finished the first session about 2 to 3 hours. They went for break and they came back again. And in that break, when she came out, I said, how was it? I said, it was tough. How about your lawyer? I said, my lawyer was just looking. Not even a word came out from her mouth. Every question was directed to her. You are to provide the answer. Lawyer was just there, looking. When the break was over, she went for second session. Another 2-3 hours. When she came out, he said, welcome to Canada. It was tough. Why was it so? Because of the foundation. The story she put it. If you are going in for hearing, I'm not going against you, I'm not against you. But don't depend on the story you put there. Trust God. I know of somebody who went for hearing, a male, and she called my wife. I said, please, can you just pray for me? I want to go for hearing. And my wife prayed with him. He went. And they entered the panel. She said, where are you from? They're from Nigeria. Oh, Nigeria, they have played soccer. The member discussed soccer. He was looking. Initially, he was frozen, but now we're going to talk about soccer all along. Every minute, they're talking about soccer. Less than 1 hour, they said, welcome to Canada. He went out. Less than 1 hour. But for another woman, 6 hours at a stretch. Went for break and came back. When the foundation is right, things fall into pleasant places for you. Are you ready to make your foundation right tonight? Yours may not be hearing. Your foundation could be like a young lady we had a deliverance on in this auditorium. While the deliverance was going on, the demon spoke and said, we are not going to leave her alone because her father introduced her to us at Ikoba River. Some of us don't know that. Ikoba River is from Edo State in Benin City. Said before she left for Europe, her father took her to that river to bait her, do some rituals. But she never knew what was going on. That was where they introduced her to the marine spirits. From Europe, she came to Canada. Life was so bad. The foundation. What is in your foundation? The foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous do? I'm not here tonight just to preach. We are going to pray. Your level must change. Your status must change. When others are celebrating, you have to celebrate. Because we are in the same land where others are getting the treasure of the land. You are entitled to that same treasure. Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Just give us brief examples and Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. A story about Jericho. When Joshua waged war against Jericho, in verse 26, or let's take from verse 25 down. And Joshua saved Rahab, the harlot, alive, and her father's household, and all that she had, and she dwelt in Israel even unto this day, because she hid the messengers which Joshua sent to spy out Jericho. In verse 26, after defeating Jericho, and Joshua adjudged them at that time, saying, cursed be the man before the Lord that rise up and build this city, Jericho. He shall lay a foundation thereof in his firstborn, and in his younger son shall he set up the gates of it. In other words, when he destroyed Jericho, he said, any man that will rise up and say he wants to build the city of Jericho, as they lay the foundation, the firstborn of that man will die. You know, there are two things that happen when you are raising a structure. Gate is the last thing they build. The first thing is the foundation of the building. They build the house, finish everything. Now the last thing is to make the fence and set up the gate. And Joshua said, whosoever that will lay the foundation, as he laid the foundation, the firstborn will die. And as he set up the gates, the lastborn will die. A curse already on the foundation of Jericho. In 1 Kings 16 verse 34, if you are there, please just take it out to save time. 1 Kings chapter 16 verse 34. 1 Kings 16, verse 34. No fast reader in the house. A decree has been made, such a pronunciation has been made against Jericho. He realized, well, after Jericho remained like this, let us build it again. And he stood up. As he was laying the foundation, the firstborn son died. And as he was setting up again, the last son died. Any mistake of your father or your mother that will cost your life, I terminate it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
What is the foundation that was laid by your grandparents? Your parents could be Christians today. Just as my children grew up and meet daddy to be a pastor, mommy to be a pastor. They don't have an idea how their grandpa once worshipped idols. They don't have an idea how their great-grandfathers once worshipped idols. If situation like that is not rectified, they continue with the foundation that was laid by parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents. Praise the name of the Lord. Genesis chapter 9. Genesis chapter 9, verse 17 to 27. And God said unto Noah, this is the token of the covenant which I have established between me and all flesh that is upon the earth, and the sons of Noah that went forth of the ark were Shem and Ham and Japheth. And Ham is the father of Canaan. These are the three sons of Noah, and of them was the whole earth overspread. And Noah began to be a husbandman, and he planted a vineyard, and he drank of the wine and was drunken, and he was uncovered within his tent. And Ham, the father of Canaan, saw the nakedness of his father, and told his two brethren without. And Shem and Japheth took a garment, and laid it upon their father's shoulder, and went backward, and covered the nakedness of their father, and their faces were backward. And they saw not their father's nakedness. And Noah awoke from his wine, and knew what his younger son had done unto him. And he said, cursed be Canaan, a servant of servants shall he be unto his brethren. And he said, blessed be the Lord God of Shem, and Canaan shall be his servant. God shall enlarge Japheth, and he shall dwell in the tent of Shem, and Canaan shall be his servant. Listen, in verse 22, the Bible says, and Ham, the father of Canaan. If I ask us what we understand by that, we'll say, no, Canaan is a son that Ham gave birth to. What the Bible is saying there is that Ham, his other name is Canaan. That is the root where Canaan started from. He gave birth to sons and daughters. Those who are continuing to increase. From there you have the nation called the Canaanite, the land that God promised to give to the children of Israel. Why? Because of the wrong foundation. He saw the father's nakedness. He had pleasure in it. For him to cover his father's nakedness, he did not. He went to call his other brothers. Come and see this old man. He's already drunk. Look at the way he's behaving. Irrespective that he was drunk, he knew what was happening. Have you ever seen someone who was drunk, staggering by the roadside? Have you come across any? Let me see. If you don't, you'll see something. A drunkard man can never be so drunk that he will not know his road to his house. No matter where he's coming from, he will still find his way. Have you seen someone that is drunk and go to the police and say, oh, can you open the door for me? Let me come here back to my home. Open, please. Open the door. They will never. They will still find their way to their house. So in the midst of his drunkenness, he was still able to know what was happening. When the drink went away, he stood up. He said, you, because you have done that, a servant of servants shall you be. And if you look at the land of Canaan, it was so rich. They have the abundant resources. But they still end up to become slaves to the Israelites because of the foundation that was wrong. Shem, if you look at the history, if you trace it, that is where Abraham came from. And that was where the Israelites came out from. The foundation. God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I trust God that the blood of Jesus is going to make the foundation right for us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Genesis 19, verse 29, to 38. Genesis 19. From verse 29. And it came to pass, when God destroyed the city of the plain, that God remembered Abraham and sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow. he and his two daughters. This was after the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. Now Lot with his two wives, no son-in-law, nobody. They are not left alone. In verse 31, and the firstborn daughter said unto the younger, our father is old, and there is not a man in the earth to come in unto us. In other words, there is no man to sleep with us after the manner of all the earth. Come, let us make our father drink wine, and we will lie with him, that we may preserve seed of our father. And they made their father drink wine that night. And the firstborn went in and lay with her father, and he perceived not when she lay down, nor when she arose. And it came to pass on the morrow that the firstborn said unto the younger, behold, I lay yesternight with my father. Is that not rape? Huh? Daughters raping their father. It's so amazing. The devil is wicked. Rape is not when they compel you. It's when something is done against your wish. Praise the Lord. We'll leave that for another day. In verse 34, he said, and it came to pass on the morrow that the firstborn said unto the younger, behold, I lay yesternight with my father. Let us make him drink wine this night also, and go down in and lie with him, that we may preserve seed of our father. They knew their father's weakness. They knew that his problem is drink. May the enemy not get into your weakness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When your foundation is weak, it's an open door for the enemy. They knew that the foundation of Lot is to drink wine. He's a drunkard. He loved you so much. A man of God. Was he not a man of God? He was. It is said that he's not a prophet like Abraham. He was a man of God. In verse 35, and they made their father drink wine that night also. And the younger arose and lay with him. And he perceived not when she lay down, nor when she arose. Thus were both the daughters of Lot with child by their father. And the firstborn bare a son, and called his name Moab. And the same is the father of the Moabite until this day. The younger, she also bare a son, and called his name Ben-Ami. The same is the father of the Ammon, which is the Ammonite, until this day. Look at the life. Time is not there. Look at their life. These were the people, when the Lord made a law that you should not uncover your father's nakedness or sleep with your father's wife. That was what they were doing. Why? Because the foundation has been made wrong. At the foundation, the sin of incest was there. And if you look at this part of the world, that is one of the most commonest thing in this part of the world, the sin of incest. I believe you may have heard some people talking on the TV that their father molested them at their childhood. It's a common occurrence in this part of the world. But I know it's not common in African continent, where I'm coming from. It's not a common thing. The foundation. When the foundation go bad, a lot of things will follow. Praise the name of the Lord. Brethren, I want us to look at our foundation. Is there a curse in the foundation of your life? Lastly, Genesis 15, 18 to 21. Genesis 15, 18 to 21. In the same day, the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying, unto thy seed have I given this land, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates, the Kenite and the Kenizzite and the Kadmonite, the Hittite and the Perizzite, and the Rephaites, and the Amorites, and the Canaanites, and the Gigashites, and the Jebusites. These are the people in the land that God promised the children of Israel to destroy because they had a bad foundation. It's just the beginning of the journey, brethren. If the foundation is made right tonight, before the middle of this program, somebody is going to smile.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Sometimes you wonder, what sin have I committed? Why is it that things are not working out right with me? I told us one time when we were in evangelism at Abion Mall, I saw one young man, he's from Ghana. While we gave him flyer, he began to talk and talk and talk. This land is bad, this land is stupid, this land is useless, nothing good comes out of this land. I was just looking at him while he was just talking. He made amends on this of Canada, finished Canada. If you are coming to this land for the first time and you meet people like that, your future is gone. He will kill your dream and kill your vision. Say, look, I have been here for over 20 years. Look at my life. Honestly, he was like a wretched, worse than a wretched man. When he finished, I knew where his problem is coming from. And he was just talking. Instead of him to trace the cause of the problem, he was not putting the problem on Canada, that the system is bad. When he finished, I said, come, my friend. Go back. Go to your roots from Africa. There are things that your parents did that have gone wrong, which has not been rectified. None of you rectify it, you will not see the light in this land. The problem you have is not Canada. Canada is a land where we make our money, just like the land of Canaan. It's a land of opportunity. If there is something wrong in your life that needs to be put right. If you go back to your roots, what your fathers did, what your forefathers did, go and find out and begin to break the things you need to break. The light. There are things that hinder the light, the shield that prevents the light from coming into your life. When those shields are broken, you begin to see the light. Was looking at me. That was the last I saw. If I was seen, I would not even know him again, honestly. And I pray that God will minister to him that word and make him to realize it. Are you here tonight? You are putting the blame on Canada. Or you've moved through so many countries. And already in Canada, you are preparing to move to whatever country. People rush to London. Those in London, they are migrating to Canada today. Am I right? London, I'm coming. Those in Italy, they are migrating to Canada. Those in Spain, they are migrating to Canada. Oh, that country is not well. Canada is the best land. The thing that does not make you to prosper in Spain, in London, if you don't deal with it, the same thing will make you not to prosper in Canada. I'm not being serious, but I'm telling you the reality. I met one of my clients. He said he's relocating to Edmonton. He's a non-African, a believer. He said in this area, this particular area where he's living, not even in Jordan, somewhere in Richmond he cared about. He said it's full of Indians. Different kinds of, everywhere is idol. He used the right word. He said, in this area, there are principalities and powers. He said, I have to move. Sort of prosper. I said, look, my friend, you are going. Do you know where you are heading to? You think there are no principalities and powers over there? The ones that are working against you, not until you bend their head. As you are moving, they know that you are going there. They will be there waiting for you. They have the network. Brethren, every satanic network that have been working against you, I break them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The power that has been standing on your foundation, working against your foundation, that says you have been in this land for many years, that the same way you came, that is the same way you will return. I terminate that power in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Shall we rise to our feet? foundation be destroyed, what would the righteous do? Sometimes we link it to racial discrimination. I've told us before, I said, I'm a black man with a difference. Anywhere I go, they will accept me. You have no choice because my father that is above is ahead of me. If you say you don't want to see black, when you see me, we accept black because I'm different. When the devil gave you the notion that these people, they are racist, the devil will use that to work against you. Anywhere they said no blacks can walk there, I'll be the first black to walk there.
Amen.
And that is my faith, and it works effectively. Because the Bible said the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. Several times said,
my Father,
I request the blood of Jesus
into
my foundation. Every mistake in my foundation, since I entered this land, Father, let the blood of Jesus make it right. Pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the blood of Jesus make it right. Every mistake I have made since I entered this land, I request the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Into my foundation right now. I ask the blood of Jesus into my foundation. I ask the blood of Jesus into the foundation of my life. I ask the blood of Jesus into my foundation. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
In the name of Jesus, he made right. In the name of Jesus, release the blood.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
I don't want to blame you so much. We are just kicking off. Amen.
Amen.
And I will quickly let us know that witchcraft pattern of prayer is a sin before God. I know that some of us don't understand that. Those who have been with me along, you understand that. There is a witchcraft pattern of prayer. Father, blood of Jesus, just go into the foundation of my life and make it right. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, just make it right. In the name of Jesus. Do we get that? It's a witchcraft pattern of prayer. Amen.
Amen.
But if you want, Bible says from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence taketh it what? By force. For somebody in your foundation, there is a strong man. That strong man does not appreciate negotiation. Remember the Bible says that when Jesus got into the temple, he saw those who were selling doves, who were doing money gambling, who were doing different kinds of things in the church. Do you think, did he talk to them and said, bros, this is the house of God, why are you doing things like that? You don't do that. Can you just stop that, your gambling, remove it? You know, we must send pigeon here. This is, we're supposed to pray, just put your pigeon back into your cage. Come on, bros, come on. No sheep, you don't send sheep in the house of God. Was that the way he talked to them?
No.
The Bible says he drove them out with force. We came, he flogged them. He turned their table of the money changing upside down aggressively. There is a kind of anger that is not offensive before God. There is a kind of anger that you will have, it is not a sin. Don't console yourself and say, the Bible says, be not angry. And be angry and sin not. So there should not be angry. The spiritual aggressiveness that need to go into the foundation or brute that thing, that spirit, that strong man that is operating against your life through that foundation. You hear, you lose opportunity. In time past, you cannot explain. Listen, when we make the foundation right tonight, there are blessings that will be coming into your life.
Yeah.
Even with happy body. You will work little, you will earn much.
Yeah.
That is the mighty hand of God that is upon this program.
Amen.
Don't look at the numbers that are here tonight. Are you hearing me? Everyone is to his own business, to his or her own business. As I am preaching to you, I am talking to God about my own life. There are things in my foundation that I will say, God, make it right for me to shine more than the way I am now. Are you hearing me? Say, Father.
Father.
Any rock foundation in my life. Father of Canaan saw the nakedness of Noah, and Noah placed a curse on him. In generations to come, they did not know what their forefather did. Were they? They had all the resources. The Israelites got to that land, they saw the fruit, the grapes, the pomegranate, the abundance of the land, they saw it. But the people were in the midst of abundance. But still, they were not prospering. Because of the mistake of one man. The children of Moabites, did they realize, did they know the mistake their first mother made at the beginning? The one that raped Lot. Their father. I hope we follow the story. When Lot's daughter raped her father and gave birth to a son and called the name Moab, the Bible says that is the father of the Moabites in this day. The children of Moab, they knew that a woman raped the father, that was a curse upon them. No, they never knew. Nobody told them that that was their root. What was the mistake of your forefathers? What was the error of your forefathers? Listen, a hunter, in the midst of about five hunters, one of them has charm on the cap. You know, when they do charm for protection, one of them has a very powerful charm. To them it's powerful. To me it is not. And that charm is meant to protect. And one of the hunters knew that his friend has a heart that is full of charm and is powerful. You know what he did? He stole the cap before that guy came back. He just dropped it and went into the bush. I think he came back. About four hunters together, the cap disappeared. Who took my cap? All of them were there. Who stole the cap was there, looking at him. Nobody could admit that he stole it. And the man said, well, if I cannot find the person that stole that cap, whosoever stole my cap, he will die of stomach pain. His children, his grandchildren. The man was hearing him, he kept quiet. Suddenly, the man developed stomach pain. He died. His children, one after the other, began to die of stomach pain. When they go to the hospital, they say it's an ulcer, no cure. It is spiritual. Medication could not work it. How do I know? One of the children came to me and said, I have something to tell you. Many of my siblings have died of stomach pain. What is the problem? He said, I'm afraid. He said, go back and find out. When he came back, the grandmother gave him the story. He said, as I'm talking to you now, my own brother is complaining of that stomach pain. I don't want to die. We organize a deliverance. It is easy for a woman to fall under anointing or that deliverance. It is difficult for a man to fall under anointing. But on that very day, when this young man twisted himself on the ground, my God, I could not believe my eyes. Because of that spirit, the foundation has been made wrong. Somebody hearing me? Your grandparents may have gone, but the Lord will make this right for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, Father.
Father.
Every strong man in my foundation.
Every strong man in my foundation.
Wherever you are. Your strong man of foundation. I approach you, my father. We worship the area. who they deal with. You don't make them to pay tax the way you pay tax. But they don't enjoy the benefit of the land. There are things they have done in their past. Because of the curse in the land, that is why you see all these symptoms of gay and lesbian or different kinds of nasty things taking place, shooting and killing all over the places. I'm going to break that curse and you get the good of the land. We'll break that curse that you will not partake in the curse of the land. Your children will not partake in the curse of the land. There was still a curse in the foundation. They had military men that were huge. If you remember those who went there to spy the land, they said we were just like them, like grasshoppers. But still, they could not do anything. In spite of the admonition, they were still powerless because it was a curse upon them. Lift up your right hand to heaven. Say, Father, every curse in the foundation of this land,
every curse in the foundation of this land,
by the blood of Jesus Christ, I break it down. Every curse in the foundation of this land, by the blood of Jesus, because there was a legal ground of parents. The reason why the Ammonites and the Moabites were defeated because there was a legal ground. Somebody may say, oh, because God was on their side. If you look at the life of Israel, when they sinned against God, they were defeated by the enemy. When they went war against Aijalon, popularly called Ai, the enemy defeated them. Joshua cried and said, what has happened, Lord? What have we done? He said, because Israel have sinned against me. That was when Achan took the Babylonish garment and God turned his face. Because there was a legal ground for the enemy to defeat them. Anything that represents legal ground in your foundation, you will be destroyed tonight.
Yeah. Amen.
That legal ground is an opportunity for the enemy. Sometimes we pray a kind of prayer and say, Lord, let my enemy make mistake that will lift me up. Don't we? We pray that prayer. Sometimes you make mistake that make the enemy to take an advantage. And when you make that mistake, you don't know. That is why we have to be very careful. And you don't take it and say it does not matter. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Every legal ground in the foundation of your life, which the enemy capitalized upon, shall be erased tonight in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Lift up the word of God unto heaven. The Bible says, thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established. Say, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every power operating against me through my foundation. Every power in this land operating against me through my foundation. Every power from my country operating against me. Every power operating against your life, wherever they are, let them die. In the name of Jesus, let them die. In the name of Jesus, let them die. In the name of Jesus, let them die. Every power operating against my life, die by fire.
I command them to die in the name of Jesus.
It's going to catch fire in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every garment of rejection, every garment of failure at the edge of success, every garment of financial struggle that have placed over you, every garment of marital rejection, the fire of God is coming upon them tonight.
Amen.
The fire of God is coming upon them tonight.
Amen.
Fire! Brethren, there's going to be an explosion. explosion comes before next week Friday, don't stay home. Continue to fire on. Are you getting me? When you receive the explosion, you have to stay home. Say, well, what I just received this week, I've never received something in Canada. Let me enjoy. Don't act like that foolish man who said, ah, my soul, relax and enjoy yourself when you see so many yams in the barn. And what does the Lord say to him? Say, you foolish man, your soul shall be required of thee. Let me see how you will enjoy those yams. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
When you have the explosion, do we enjoy it?
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Say, Father. And I don't know. God don't tell me it's because of this person, it's because of Simeon, it's because of the Christian, it's because of even me, the preacher. He don't say. But once you release it, connect yourself into it.
Yes.
Say, Father. Father side, mother side, all of them gathering together. You know, when they come for family meeting, your house is filled up. problem of a man, mostly 90% or more, is family witchcraft. For somebody, that witch is going to die tonight.
Yeah. Amen.
I don't know. So the one in my family, I'm still killing them. And I will continue to kill them. They are very wicked. I'm going to use knife. If I use knife, they will arrest me. It's prayer I used to kill them. They don't like anything good. Go and put power in their village. They will try to kill you. Isn't it? You put bottle there for them so they won't suffer, they won't be going to the stream to drink contaminated water. But because you put bottle there, they will try to come and kill you. You put light there, they will target you. They don't like anything good. That witch in the family will die in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen!
They cannot break from fire, they cannot break from me. So somebody, they knew that when you step into this land, we assume that there is nothing. Like a Jamaican pastor who said to me, he has been pastoring for 20 years, and he said to me, he said, you sure there is a witch in this land? I said, yes. And there's no witch. I said, you are a pastor? And there's no witch in this land? He said, they don't use you as barbecue. It's not the way the environment is. That's why Paul Luba said there is no witch in the land. We are here. The difference between the witch in this land and the witch in Africa is that the witch in this land, they wear suit in the wardrobe. The one in Africa, they put on rag. When you see them, it's here. This one is. Somebody gave me a story when a witch in the Western world visited a witch in Africa. And he said, he went to this house. He said, is it the house you live on earth? He said, this kind of house you live here, yes. You are rich on the other side, and you are so wretched here. That is the way they are. May God help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Any witch in your family will die in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For someone, not until they die, you cannot have a breakthrough, but you have a choice. Say you want to let them live, good luck. Are you hearing me? That's the last prayer which I'm giving to us tonight. So that we'll move on. We'll go to meet next week Friday. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Shall we just write for the last prayer point on this? The Bible says, thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. Wherever you are coming from is the ninth hour over there. Are you hearing me, brother? This is the ninth hour. In Africa, wherever you are coming from, they are in operation at this hour. It's 5 hour difference from Africa now, especially in Nigeria. I believe the same thing for Ghana. 5 hours different. 4 hours. Or people are nearer to this side than us. Amen. Wherever they are, the Lord is going to kill them in that meeting.
Amen.
Wherever they plan evil against you, they've been operating against you, the Lord is going to kill them tonight.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Say, Father.
Father.
Any witch in my family. Precious Father, I thank you. Lord, you love your children. For that reason, you released this program. You said, call a solemn assembly. Here are your people, desiring a change in their lives. Lord, you have been doing a great job. Greater works you will do.
Amen.
As your servant, Lord, I release the blood of Jesus upon the foundation of their lives.
Amen.
I release the blood of Jesus upon the foundation.
Amen.
Mighty God, every error they made in the foundation of their life in this land, I ask thee for mercy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, every error in their foundation based on the family history, Lord, I ask thee for mercy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever that has been working against them through their foundation, I terminate them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
From today, I call a turnaround of your life for good in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Spirit of God, begin to release upon your children that which has been lost in the past in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The God of heaven and earth, you brought them into this land, not by accident, but by divine arrangement.
Amen.
And for divine purpose. Father, let that purpose be accomplished in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This is the beginning of the program, Lord. I break every veil of spiritual blindness.
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty, as we continue in this journey, let the eyes of your children open to recover in the name of Jesus Christ. Every veil covering your life, I break it open in the name of Jesus. Every veil working against people, I break it open in the name of Jesus Christ. That which you have lost in the past years, I command a recovery and restoration in Jesus' name. Thank you, merciful Father. Every power that will reinforce to work against you, I set their kingdom on fire in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.